What did your grandmother say?
She said that my mother was wrong, that Lenny isn't unstable, it's just that he wasn't in a war like World War II, which was patriotic. So that's what makes Lenny automatically neurotic.
What did your father say?
He said that I should never have gotten engaged to anybody so much older in the first place. 10 years, he says, is too much of a difference in years. Same old thing. And he says the reason Lenny sometimes has those moody spells is because he had to fight a war that wasn't a war. Just a meaningless conflict. That's it, conflict. My father was in the Korean War, and he says that was a war. And Lenny says it wasn't a war, but a police action, whatever that is. Like all that PLO and Falklands in Argentina and all that back and forth stuff like that, I think.
What did your Aunt Shirley say?
Oh, her engaged to be engaged is not engaged, Sandra. Show me that ring, sweetie, then I believe. She's so vicious.
My father was in the Korean War, too.
Regional situation, yeah.
Yep.
He's at a meeting right now. Can I help?
He loves MASH. I mean, he loves it. He watches it religiously. He wouldn't miss an episode, even the rerun.
No, I'm not his secretary. I'm his assistant.
My father hates MASH.
How come?
He says it makes him sick to his stomach.
Fine. How come?
My Uncle Sam, my father's younger brother, his only brother, he was killed in Korea.
That's sad.
I know. Bye-bye.
Do you remember your Uncle Sam?
How could I? I wasn't even born before he was dead.
Well, that's...
Regional circulation.
But you couldn't tell he wore a mustache from the time he was 15. He was handsome, even though he did have a hair lip.
No, he's in a meeting.
Oh, that's so sad.
Fine. But you couldn't tell he had it. My father said never bothered my Uncle Sam.
Bye-bye.
My father still has shrapnel on his leg. I mean, hit by a bomb.
He's not recovered, but there's still a little bit in there that never got out.
So that's what makes him limp when it's foggy.
Regional circulation.
Hey.
What?
How could your father go to Korea? I thought he was born in Ireland. I thought he grew up there.
He did, but when he got over here at 17, he had to join the army to become a citizen.
No one's at a meeting right now.
Now I see.
Can I have him call you back?
Hey, did you see that old movie on Channel 9 last night with John Wayne about Ireland? The Quiet Man?
Uh-huh. Oh, yeah. My father always watches it.
My father likes it, too.
Bye-bye. My mother likes it, too.
My Aunt Shirley hates it. She says John Wayne was nothing but an old right-wing fart. But she has that attitude about just everything.
A lot of those old movies on TV are better.
Stories.
Oh! Hello, Mrs. Penn.
I love those old war movies with the romance back home.
No, Norman's at a meeting right now.
Someone waiting, someone caring, and I like that.
Yeah, me too. They're corny, but they're good.
How's the baby?
There's this one about this blind war veteran, and he doesn't want this girl to love him because he's blind, and so he drinks with his old buddies at a bar, and he's drunk one night, and he falls, and then she comes to rescue him, and then he sleeps it off, and then he wakes up, and then he realizes he can't still love her, even if he is blind.
I didn't see that. What's the name of it?
Oh, how cute.
Something, I can't remember. Oh, and this other one about the nurses on some island. Baton. And this one nurse has a hand grenade and she puts it in her shirt, right against her heart, right under her left boob, and she walks right towards the Japs and she gets blown up and she saves her lives. I love that.
I saw that. That was good. What was the name of it?
Something like Stars and Stripes Forever. Something like that.
I'm so proud of you, Miguel.
Oh, how cute.
Was that it? Was that the name? I think so. I think you're right, John.
The one I like is the one with Marlon Brando, and he's a paraplegic, and his girl still loves him anyway. And he wants to stay in the hospital and keep suffering with all the other paraplegic guys from the war. And he says he'll be all right, and then he feels real sorry for himself, and then she cries, and then he cries, and they both hug and cry.
Of course.
It was true.
The Marlon Brando wasn't that one about Vietnam.
Yeah, Apocalypse Now.
That sucked. Did you see that, John?
Yes.
Did you like it? I hated it. Have you ever been in a war movie?
No, not yet.
But that commercial you said you did was for the army, so that's sort of like being in a war movie.
I'll tell him.
Bye-bye.
Colleen, it's been 2 hours. Don't forget to take your medicine.
Thanks for reminding me, Sandra.
How many bridesmaids are you going to have, Sandra?
4.
Will you be wearing white?
Of course.
What color are my bridesmaids today?
Powder blue. I like them all in powder blue. My maid won't have to wear either gold or lemon.
Gold or lemon? Was that clash with powder blue?
No. Me and my mother are going to start planning the guest list this weekend.
Aren't you getting ahead of yourself?
Colleen, we're getting married in a year. What's wrong with pre-planning?
You're just engaged to be engaged. No ring yet.
You sound like my Aunt Shirley.
Well,
Colleen, yesterday you told me that when you and Marco get married, you want 2 of your bridesmaids in pink and 2 of your bridesmaids in peach.
I said if and when I get married to Marco.
Where will you get an apartment? Queens?
No, I think it'd be best for both of us to be away from our parents. Maybe Brooklyn.
We live in a section that's still decent.
We're not going to live in Lenny's apartment, that's for sure. It's as big as a pizza. traveling an hour to work every day.
I wouldn't want to live here.
Me either. It's a jungle.
He says he wants to live in Greenwich Village.
Oh, no. But you?
I don't know. You see, he goes there twice a week. That's where his therapist is.
Lenny goes to a therapist?
Yeah.
Why?
He says it helps him keep a balance.
He has to keep balance if he's going to marry you.
Oh, shut up! Reachable situation.
Oh. Hi, Lenny.
Yes, she is. Hold on.
Hi, honey!
Why are you those questions?
Your wife called today. She said your son took his first steps.
About time. He's almost two. What is this? I ordered beige, lavender, olive, and cerise.
Yes. I didn't think you were my mom or my dad.
Well?
Well, what?
This is brown, not beige. This is purple, not lavender. This is green, not olive. And this is...
red, not cerise.
Exactly. I can show you the color bill in my office. Those dunderheads in printing, they mangle everything. That dumb midget and that dumb chick color these labels. They must be retyped today.
What's wrong with them?
That type we had before John. She's retyped them on large labels instead of small labels.
Oh, these? I thought you wanted them on large labels.
No, I wanted them on small labels, not the large labels. I wanted to address the purchase manager, not the personnel manager. Now, shall I give them to you to give to him, or shall I give them to him directly yourself?
You can give them to him if you'd like, Norman, or I can give them to him if you prefer.
I'll give them to him, Norman.
All right, Norman.
Didn't think you meant my Aunt Shirley or my brother.
Are you sure? Your official title now is Regional Circulation Assistant. I wouldn't want you to feel that I'm infringing on your new responsibilities.
Oh, Norman.
I'm glad to hear that, Norman.
I didn't think you were my family or my closest friends.
Then you'll give these to John.
This is correct. I'll give them to him right now.
That's not true. I can be trusted.
John, how you doing?
Fine, thank you.
I just wanted to let you know how much we've appreciated your work in the last 4 weeks.
Thank you.
You are Wiz, the best temperance I've ever had in 6 months.
Thank you.
I know you need extra time some days to go into acting auditions, rough racket show business. I know you take your lunch hour on time, so if you need extra time some days, please let us know it. Time, buddy.
Thank you.
Of course, you get paid by the hour. There's no change on that. But if you need for an extra hour or so, we can make adjustments for you if the need arises.
Thank you.
Nope, you're welcome, buddy. Now, would you put all that work aside and complete these labels? Retype them on small labels, not the big labels.
I am, buddy.
Address to the purchase manager, not the personnel manager. I'd like them completed by 5.
There are a lot of labels here.
Give it your best shot, buddy. If we bend a little for you, bend a little for us. I'm sure we can.
I am an honorable person.
Marta, I want all of us to start cutting down on excessive telephone calls.
The telephone tempers the tension of the tedium.
What?
The telephone
tempers. I heard you. Type the labels down.
That's why I'm here, buddy.
Marta, come into my office and bring those ugly brochures.
I'll be right there, Norman.
Now, Marta.
In a second, Norman. Lenny, I'm not unreasonable. Lenny, you're unreasonable.
Regional circulation?
Any messages for John
Trainer?
Oh, hi, Marco.
I'm upset. I'm better.
You're going to make me cry.
Yes, I've been taking my medicine like a good little girl.
I did not break the promise.
Marco, I'm 19.
I did not break it.
I'm too young to get an ulcer, aren't I?
I simply told people into my confidence.
And you rest today?
That is not breaking the promise.
I know you are. Thanks for calling, Marco. You're nice.
Lenny!
No messages?
Me too.
Lenny?
Alright, thank you, bye.
Lenny hung up on me.
Is anything wrong?
He hung up on me. He never did that before. I'm just gonna cry.
Don't, Sandra. Bowden will see you.
He's talking to Marta. He won't see me.
You're going to cry. Go to the ladies' room and cry. I did it last Thursday after I was mugged. It helps.
Oh, it's so awful.
What's so awful?
I can't talk about it.
Go on, talk about it.
I can't, Holly.
Let it out, Sandra. Let it out.
I can't. I just can't.
Let it out or you'll get gastritis.
Like me. Lenny broke off our engagement to be engaged.
Oh no, is that why he hung up on you?
I gotta call my mother.
No! Lenny's gonna piss and move today. Look at him with Marta. Look at that face. Don't get on the phone again right away.
Lenny was so awful, Colleen. I said I wouldn't tell anybody except my mother, my father, my brother, my grandmother, my Aunt Shirley. She can't keep her mouth shut. About anything! Would I have to tell her, even though she did respond negatively, which isn't unusual. She'd be on my case for weeks.
These were her rights, Mitch. Well, I blame Leah. She was my mistake. Because on the subway this morning, she said four people from the neighborhood congratulated him on his engagement. And at the office, he got three phone calls. He said he knew he couldn't trust me. He said that I was unreasonable. I tried to reason with him, but he said that I was an unreasonable person. What a thing to say! Maybe I should have kept going with his brother, Moses. Maybe. No, Polly. Moses is immature. He's only 24. My age. A man is very immature at 24. You know that. We all know that. Not like a woman. Lenny's mature. He's neurotic, but mature. He said he didn't want to announce our engagement to be engaged until after he got the results of the Veterans Hospital yesterday. He's worried, you see, about Agent Orange, because his hair's beginning to fall out. I never told you! He's beginning to lose his hair!
A lot of men lose their hair young. My mom was all the way bald. 35.
Lenny's only 34. Should I call his mother? Why, poor she's such a pain in the ass.
Oh, she is. Maybe she'll love something that I don't know, right?
What's Agent Orange?
Maybe I should call my father.
Easy on the phones today. Norman's ready for war. Let's not aggravate more than necessary.
I refuse to quiet over that bastard.
Lenny?
Son of a bitch.
Lenny?
Prick.
What happened?
I refuse to cry.
What happened with Lenny?
I can't talk about it.
After they got engaged to be engaged last night, Sandra promised that she wouldn't tell anyone except her mother, her father, her grandmother, and her brother.
And her Aunt Shirley.
And her Aunt Shirley. And her best friend Rachel.
Who's going to be my maid of honor, and also Leah, who's going to be one of my bridesmaids.
Leah was the mistake, because on the subway this morning, five people congratulated Lenny, and at his office, 10 people called.
And he hung up on me.
He didn't want to announce they were engaged to be engaged until after the results of his examination at the vet's hospital yesterday. He's worried about Agent Orange because his hair is falling out. Are you sure you don't want a Kleenex, Sandra?
What's Agent Orange? Like,
no, it's something our government used to use in Vietnam. Some kind of a spray.
Spray? You mean like a chemical?
Something like that.
Agent Orange is a herbicide they use in Vietnam to defoliate the jungle.
What does defoliate mean?
It would strip the trees of their leaves so you could see your way. See the enemy. But since then, many veterans have died of cancer, some have hair loss, and others have become impotent.
Bloody's not that.
You know what that means.
All the balls are made of blood defects, and in some cases, because of exposure to it, children are born deformed.
Deformed?
Ugh! He didn't tell me about that!
How did he scare you?
I'm going to call back right now.
Go to the ladies room first, Sam.
Why?
Just to sit and think and pee a little. You don't want to grab the trap to say if you did call back. Time to put yourself together.
Yes.
Come with me.
No, no one will have a heart attack.
Screw him.
No. Colleen's right. Look at the way he's looking at us through the window.
Look at him stare.
Smile.
Oh, that face. Like a rat.
Sorta.
Colleen, I'm not going into the bathroom to cry. I know. I'll have some water. And I don't care what Norman Ratface thinks about that.
Colleen, come with me with water back. Please, don't just stand there. Come with me, please.
Don?
I was in the army.
Vietnam?
Yes.
Was it terrible?
Yes.
Did you have to kill anybody?
Yes.
How many?
Too many.
Do you think there'll be a nuclear war next?
Well, if there is, we'll all get dead.
Oh, there'll be some safe places. There'll be places on Long Island.
What makes you say that?
Because Long Island's like that. Regional circulation. She's away from her desk. Yes, I'm with his calling, please. Thank you, Mrs. Dugan. Bye-bye.
Where did Colleen and Sandra go?
Water fountain.
Really?
Yes.
How odd.
Is it?
Thirsty at the exact same time.
Sandra said she was thirsty, and because she said it, then Colleen discovered that she was too.
I got it. Oh, you mean the power of suggestion.
Yes.
You'd think that yawning is the same kind of thing as being thirsty. Yawning is much more contagious than being thirsty.
Maybe.
It is.
Maybe.
I said it isn't, it is, John. Marta, call that dumb bitch and that dumb chick about the brochure colors and get it corrected.
I thought you wanted to.
You're the original circulation assistant. You need new responsibilities to stretch. Stretch.
I'm going to come back right now and confront you face to face.
Colleen, your mother called.
Oh, thanks, Moyra.
Hello, Tiny. This is Moyra.
I'd like to speak to Lenny.
Moyra from Regional Circulation.
on duty.
I know I'm not.
He just arrested some guy for beating his wife with a hammer.
Hello, this is John Traynor. Is Adam there?
Cops are entitled to breaks like everybody wants, and we got a couple minutes, and so he called me because he's concerned about me.
Yes, I'll hold on until he's off the other line.
Sure, I'll hold on.
Bitch. I'm calling for Norman because he wanted me to explain to you what he ordered.
Why are you being so nasty about Marco? He does his job, Mom. He's a good cop. He hardly takes any crap.
Tiny, I have a Xerox copy here in front of me of the original order. She said, are you still there? Is she to be believed, that bitch?
What are you saying?
Lenny said she's fatter than fat. You know what I said to him? I said something for an overabundance of flesh.
I am not pregnant.
I'm holding on.
Dr. O'Keefe said it was gastritis, and that's all that's the matter with you.
He ordered the following shades. Beige, lavender, olive, and streaks. Oh, please, God. Don't let me start crying when Lenny gets on. Please let me be adult.
Mom.
God, brown for beige.
Thanks.
Purple for lavender.
Hi.
Green for olive and red for streets.
This is John.
Mom, you're not making any sense.
Did John Traynor have
it? It doesn't matter what I think, Tiny. It's what Norman ordered. And what Norman orders, Norman gets.
I'm fine. Did you hear any more about that movie Universal will be shooting here in July?
He did not order brown, purple, green, or red. He ordered beige, lavender, olive, and streets.
Don't you call me that?
Yes, Tiny, he wants them all refunded. Hi, honey. Why did you hang up on me and hurt me so?
Y'all make mistakes.
Adam, they said they liked the screen test.
Now, can you please explain to me about all this ancient orange stuff and how it affects you? I know it's a defoliate, but Tiny, you better let me speak to your boss. Defoliate, sorry.
Ma, you're talking crazy.
Let me speak to Mr. Wong. I don't want my boss going on a warpath either.
So I definitely don't have a part?
You don't stop talking like that, I'm going to move out.
Oh.
Marco is a good man and a good cop and good to me!
Adam, why didn't you call me and tell me that I lost it?
Hello, Mr. Wong. This is Marcia Perez, Regional Circulation.
Oh, don't give me that crap. You know I've been waiting to hear.
I'm listening, Lenny. About the callers?
You bet your ass I'm overly sensitive. I have been sitting here for a month. I've been typing name after name.
Italians are just as good as the Irish.
Address after address. Damn grim.
You have a fault, Wong. You watch too many soap operas. You're addicted to them like an alcoholic.
I'm trying to explain it to you now, Mr. Wong. If you give me the chance.
My employment ran out. My savings are almost gone. It's been the pits.
Don't you dare call me that again.
I said I'm listening,
Wong. Well, instead of doing your best, Adam, why don't you do a little better?
Then I'm an Irish life star.
Well, I don't like your ass, me.
You're in beige lavender.
What?
Oh, I'm sorry, Mr. Wong. I'll go slower. Beige.
I hope that.
Lavender.
I hope God forgives you.
Olive.
Fuck. Uh-huh. My mother wants me to move out just as I only get $20 a week anyway, and my sisters need my room.
The colors he did not want are. No, no, Mr. Wong, you won't go fast.
Chloe, this is John again, is out of there.
So all you've been telling me comes down to this. You're no longer engaged to be engaged to me. You don't want to marry me. And you're moving out of your old apartment in Queens to an even more expensive apartment in Greenwich Village.
Or in Evolva again.
You will not save that much money on transportation money.
You don't tell your daughter to do that when she's got gastritis.
Sell your car? How can you put it in place if you sell your car?
Purple.
You know what I think? You really want to know what I think? I think you're using all this ancient orange stuff as an excuse to end our relationship, Lenny.
Green?
Well, if you have that worry, I can share that worry with you.
Father Fitzpatrick would say, Mrs. Dugan, you have wronged your daughter.
Yes, if you feel the need to make those changes, I can make those changes with you.
Red.
But then Father Fitzpatrick would say to me, forgive your mother, Colleen Francis.
If you want me to move into Greenwich Village without an engagement ring or a wedding ring, I'll live with you for better or worse.
The problem is my mother's going through the change.
Yes! Bye-bye.
Oh, you like this cigarette.
You still love me?
I'm still holding you.
Yes, I love you too.
Where are my cigarettes?
I'll see you tonight. Bye, honey.
Where are you going with cigarettes?
Lenny's looking into a new apartment and he wants me to move in with him. Don't say it. Don't say I shouldn't because I'm going to. You know how handsome he is, Colleen. I'd better be there. He'll be eaten alive. Besides, my parents would be glad to know they'll have the room for my brother. I've lived with him long enough. And don't either of you say anything about that ancient orange stuff and deformed babies because I never said I wanted a baby.
Yes, I'm still holding.
Oh, I'm just so glad I called him back. I'd be miserable without him. He still loves me.
little kitty that much.
She just don't really listen.
Wow.
I'm not ready to go out and live on my own.
Wow.
I didn't say you were an alcoholic, Mom. If you need a drink at 11:45 in the morning, am I to say you shouldn't have it? That's for Dr. O'Keefe to decide. Didn't you say?
Wow.
So I can keep my room and we'll have to move out yet?
Wow.
Exactly.